Hi everyone, my name is Nas. I have an Etsy shop with the name Sewing Panda Patterns, where I sell digital sewing patterns. I'll leave the link in the description box, please do check. Once you got the pattern, measure the first page for accuracy, then join all the papers. All information related printing, cutting has given in the instruction file. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to stitch it with a clear and step-by-step process. So let's start with joining the side panels to the center front bodice panel with 1 cm seam allowance. Next, trim the raw edges with pinking scissors, then open the seams and press it. Repeat the same thing with the lining, and here I'm using the same fabric as lining. Then attach the both main and lining fabric with right sides together, then stitch it with 1 cm seam allowance. Now I'm going to give an understitch on the lining. Next, join the main fabric and lining all around with a 1/4 inch seam allowance. Next, coming to the back bodies, attach the side panels to the center back panels with 1 cm seam allowance, then trim the edges and press it. Repeat the same thing with the lining. As you can see, I'm using the same fabric as lining, but it's up to you. Then attach both the main fabric and lining fabrics with the right sides together with 1 cm seam allowance. Then give an understitch on the lining. Next, attach both the lining and main fabric all over, same as front bodies. Next, attach both the front and back bodies with the right sides together with 1.5 cm seam allowance. Then trim the edges and press it. Next, coming to the sleeve, fold the sleeve hem twice with a 1/2 cm, then stitch it. As you can see, I press the line from the notches to attach the elastic casing. For making elastic casing, just take the pattern piece number 6 and fold it twice on both sides like bicep making. Then give a good press. Then attach the elastic casing on the marking and give a stitch on both the edges. Here I'm using loop turner to insert the elastic, then secure it with the pins and stitch it. Next, join the sleeve sides with 1.5 cm seam allowance. Next, attach the sleeve to the bodies. As you can see, I have already attached the sleeve at one side. Same way, I'm going to attach it to the other side. Match the side seams and pin it. But at the top, leave little extra fabric and stitch it with 1 cm seam allowance. To make elastic casing, need to fold the fabric and make the channel. But since it's a curvy shape, I'm going to give basting stitching all over the sleeve head to fold the fabric easily. Next, I'm going to pull the thread little by little until it gets enough shape to make the elastic casing. Once it's done, give a good press and insert the elastic. Here I'm using small safety pin and big needle to insert the elastic. Now secure the elastic with pins and stitch it. Now coming to the skirt. Next, give notches at center and sides. Repeat the same thing with the bodies. Next, stitch 2 rows with a large stitch length to make gathers. Next, pull the thread and spread the gathers evenly, then attach it to the bodies by matching notches and stitch it with 1 cm seam allowance, then overlock it. Repeat the same thing with the second tier. Next, I'm going to attach the zipper at back side. Finish the zipper ends with a few hand stitches, then close back with a 1.5 cm seam allowance. Now the final step, fold the hem twice with a 1/2 cm, then stitch it all around.